the most difficult situation during pregnancy is to treat the pain here and there. Many women complain of headache, breast pain, back pain, pain in the costal margin, pain over the pubic bone, pain in the legs, etc. You should all remember, even though it may be normal, the woman actually suffers from the pain and it is very difficult for her. But unfortunately, we cannot give painkillers during pregnancy. Most of the painkillers will affect the heart of the baby, so we don't give. Maximum painkiller that we give is paracetamol, and paracetamol is not a great painkiller. It can reduce to some extent, and that also cannot be taken for a longer time. It can be taken only for a short while. And then what do we do with these pains? Headache you can treat with external applications, and if you practice some relaxation techniques, it may be relieved. For back pain, the commonest cause for back pain is bad posture. During pregnancy, especially in the later months of pregnancy, the abdomen enlarges, the gravity, the center of gravity of the body changes. It drags the backbone forward, so as a result, there is a back pain. And this pain can be treated by exercises. In the exercise CD, if you see, there are exercises called cat and camel exercises. The first thing that you should do is walk erect, sit erect, and do these exercises. Most of these people sitting in the office, unconsciously they hunch, 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 and then they start doing like this. If you hunch, the back pain will get aggravated. Sitting erect initially, you may be finding it a little difficult, but as you get used to it, that's the most comfortable posture you can have while sitting. And also, if the pain is severe, what you can do, you can roll a turkey towel, or you can use a small cushioned pillow in the back curve. There is a curve, isn't it, at the back. In that you keep it and then just press on the chair, you will be better. And again, if you are sitting in a moving chair, you cannot do this. So you should sit in a sofa which doesn't move, and then you can do this pressure. Or you can just simply, if you are sitting in the office, if you have pain, what you can do, you can just keep your hand like this, in the groove, like this, and then just press on it, okay? Then you will have a good relief. And you can apply some external applications for the back pain. The back pain also can be tackled by back massage. What we do in this back massage, at night, the woman, make it a bare body at the back, is made to sit in front of a table or a chair. She has to hold on to something, okay? She can sit on a chair with a table in front and then lean on the table or hold on to the table. Somebody else can, from the back, do the massage. What they have to do, there are massage oils available, or you can use any edible oil. It can be coconut oil or olive oil. You put oil in your hands, rub it nicely, and then apply on the back of the woman also. Then by this motion, like use your thumb or these fingers. Don't use your palm. This palm can be used only for people who are really obese. For thinner individual, just use your thumb and fingers. Okay, you can do this sort of movement from the shoulder till the buttocks, you can use. Then you can just a little massage, little pressure also you can give. If you do the massage and then put some hot water and then apply some painkiller ointment over the back, the back pain will go. This back massage can be done by anybody at home, by your husband or somebody who can help you. It can be done even every day also. The other pain, the commonest complaint again, is the sciatic nerve pain. The sciatic nerve pain is a shooting pain which comes from the back of the buttocks to the thighs. There is a nerve called sciatic nerve which comes from the vertebral column through the pelvis to the thighs. This sciatic nerve, if it is compressed by the backbone because of the changes that happen during pregnancy, can produce pain. This pain can be alleviated by the leg exercises. You lie down on your right or left, and then these exercises are demonstrated in the CD. You can lift up your leg 10 times. You can make your leg go forward and backward. That will help you to relieve your sciatic nerve pain. And then pubic arch, the pain in the hairy area over the lower abdomen. This pain again can be because the joints in the pelvis relax or give way so that the head can negotiate through the pelvic bone. This pain again can be tackled by exercises, by pelvic tilts, and you can apply some hot water and cold water alternatively over this area. That will produce pain. You cannot apply painkiller ointment over this area. Legs, of course, you can apply. See, many of the people, when they have pain, it is relieved by exercises. But people generally don't believe, how can pain be relieved by exercises? See, the idea is, see, supposing you sleep with this hand like this, with your head on the upper arm. After 1 hour, if you get up, you do get pain in your hands. Why is it? Because you didn't move the hand for 1 hour and it was fixed in one particular position. So when it is fixed in one particular position, one group of muscles go into spasm. This spasm will be relieved only when you do movements forward, backward, rolling movements and all that. So most of the time, even the back pain is coming because the back muscles we don't use at all, only the front muscles we use. So the exercise if you do and the back muscles stretch and contract, relax and contract, then the pain goes. Similarly for the legs also. So if you do the exercises, you will not have pain, you will feel much fresh and the blood supply to these organs will be much better. Another important pain is the abdomen pain. The upper abdomen and the lower abdomen. Upper abdomen pain is usually because of the increased acidity during pregnancy. That can be tackled with antacids, proper diet habits, and avoiding starvation for a long time. The lower abdomen pain, initial months of pregnancy, they do have something like a menstrual cramps. These are very common. If it is not very disturbing and mild, you really don't have to worry. But if you have any severe pain in the lower abdomen, anytime you should report to your doctor. It can be because of urinary infection. It can be because the pregnancy is not okay and it is trying to get aborted. Or it may be because there is a tubal pregnancy, ectopic pregnancy, which is threatening to rupture. So if the lower abdomen pain is severe and unbearable, any time of the day, any day, you should report to your doctor. A mild menstrual like cramps, you really don't have to worry. And whenever there is a pain like this, usually, especially in the first 3 months of pregnancy, we prefer to do a scan to rule out an ectopic pregnancy. Ectopic pregnancy cannot be easily diagnosed by only a clinical examination. It can be suspected by a clinical examination. And so you need to have a scan to rule out an ectopic pregnancy. Even if it is a very early pregnancy, if you do a scan, there is no harm in it. If there is no necessity, we don't do a scan. But when there is a pain which is considerable, you need a scan to rule out a tubal pregnancy. And one more pain that can again happen is the pain in the hands. See, there is a band-like tissue in this area. Okay, this band-like tissue, when the hand swells during pregnancy, just like the legs swell, a mild swelling of the hands also can occur. Supposing you put a rubber band, what will happen? That will constrict and then reduce the blood supply to these areas. Similar thing happens naturally, and as a result, the woman will have pain. More than pain, it will be sort of numbness. The women may not be able to even close the hands fully. Okay, they'll feel as if it is all swollen. That is again, to some extent it is normal, but if the hand swelling is very gross, again check your BP and urine albumin to know whether you are developing pregnancy induced hypertension. Let's see some of the skin changes that occur during pregnancy. In the later months of pregnancy, in general, there is a little extra pigmentation. As a result, the skin looks darker. The face will look darker. The abdomen will develop lines with black color. This is part and parcel of normal pregnancy. After delivery, you will get back your color and glow. So please don't worry about that. And don't try to apply some extra ointments and all that fairness cream. All that may not work. You really don't have to worry about it. And over the abdomen, you may develop what is called as striae. There will be two types of striae. One is black in color. The other one is pink or white in color. The black striae will disappear after delivery. But the white ones or the pink ones are usually because of poor elasticity of your abdominal wall. The elasticity depends on your, again, genetics and the food you take. If you take proper balanced diet, the elasticity will be good. And again, there is genetically the elasticity might vary. Okay, if it is a good elastic skin, however much it stretches, it will not produce that striae. If it is a skin with the poor elasticity, it will produce this white striae, and these striae may not disappear fully after delivery. There are ointments, moisturizing lotions available to prevent stretch marks. These ointments may not prevent it 100%, may reduce to some extent. And these later months of pregnancy, again around the 7th, 8th month, many women develop itching over the abdomen and throughout the body. This is called pruritus of pregnancy. This is because of bile stasis that happens during pregnancy. When this happens, it can be treated with tablets. Avoid oily foods, and if it is severe, tablets and ointments are available to correct this. Again, this can be so severe that every time they scratch, there may be a scratch mark over the abdomen and hands. Some people really do suffer from it very badly. And this again will disappear completely after delivery. There is one more condition called varicose veins. These varicose veins are prominent blue color tortuous vessels, veins that you see in the lower part of the body. It can occur over the genitalia, thighs and legs. During pregnancy, they may become very prominent and look scary, but you really don't have to get scared. These things again will disappear after delivery. But some of these veins can produce a little nagging pain. If it is severe and produces pain, there are stockings available. These stockings are tight socks like, which can be worn up to the thighs during daytime and can be removed during night time. If these stockings are not available, you can use an elastogrip bandage. Start from below, from your foot, and then use it till your thighs. And you should avoid prolonged standing when you have varicose veins. As far as the urinary symptoms are concerned, many of the women develop increased frequency in the first 3 months, especially between 12 to 14 weeks. Around that 12 to 14 weeks, what happens? The enlarged uterus presses upon the bladder and then makes it pass urine frequently. After 14 weeks, it goes above the pelvic bone, so it really doesn't press on it. And nearing delivery, the head presses on the bladder when it is in the lower part of the uterus, and it presses on the bladder and the person passes urine very often. Sometimes the urinary infection also is quite common during pregnancy. Normally we do a urine culture test at the beginning of the pregnancy, and if necessary, it will be done even later. Another most important symptom is itching in the genitals, external genitalia. Pregnancy per se can aggravate the itching. This itching is mainly because of an infection called Candida or Moniliasis infection. This is a fungus infection. This fungus thrives well in a moisturized place. So whenever there is an increased moisture, this infection will get aggravated. During pregnancy, because of the increased blood supply, a little extra secretion will always be there from the vagina, which leads to continuous moisture in that area, and that produces itching. But in cases of diabetes, the itching may be really worse. So whenever the woman complains of itching, the first thing that we do is to check the blood sugar. If the blood sugar is normal, then what she has to do, most important thing is she has to keep that place dry. So in our country, we don't use tissues to wipe it. We usually clean with water. After cleaning it with water, most of the people do not dry it with tissues or cloth. So as a result, the moisture, that is one reason. And because ours is a hot climate, so what happens, you sweat a lot and the sweat produces a lot of moisture. This again leads to increased incidence of fungal infection. So you have to keep that place dry. After washing it with water, wipe it dry, and there are external applications which can be applied over that area to prevent fungal infection. If it is severe and recurrent, please do look for diabetes. Another important symptom that you should also know is the edema or swelling of the legs. 30% of the women do have some amount of water retention and they have swelling of the legs. This swelling, if it is associated with an increased BP, it is dangerous. If the BP is normal and if the woman has swelling, you really don't have to worry. It may be producing pain and discomfort and all that, but that is nothing to worry. If the swelling is there and the BP is more and if there is urine albumin, then it is very significant. It may be pregnancy induced hypertension and preeclampsia, in which case the women have to be admitted and treated. But supposing there is no increase in BP, then the woman need not be admitted, does not have to be scared at all. This swelling will get aggravated on prolonged standing. So these women should avoid prolonged standing. They can walk and they can do some leg massage. Many of these women have leg cramps also. Okay. So these women, during night time, when before lying down, before going to sleep, they can do a foot and leg massage. What they do, they have to take some oil and then just do this motion from below up like that. A little massage and then put some hot water, the cramps will go. The edema may not disappear with these massage and cramps. But as I said, if it is not associated with the BP, you really don't have to worry. The edema will disappear. Edema means swelling. The edema will disappear only after delivery. That also will take about 10 to 15 days after delivery for the whole thing to subside. Other less common complaints are visual disturbances. A mild blurring may be there, again due to edema. But again, in the later months of pregnancy, if the woman has swelling, increased BP, urine albumin is plus and has visual disturbance, it may be a symptom of severe pregnancy induced hypertension, in which case she has to report to the doctor immediately. Some amount of nasal bleeding may be there commonly for some people. There may be some gum bleeding. These are all common symptoms. These are nothing to worry. For gum bleeding, again, you can consult a dentist. There are some special toothpaste and tooth powders available which can be used. Some amount of breathlessness, again, common during pregnancy. In the first 3 months of pregnancy, it is because of the hormonal changes. In the later months of pregnancy, it is because of the increasing size of the abdomen and increasing weight. This breathlessness, if it is very unusual and even at rest, if the woman is very breathless, then she should consult a physician to know if her heart and lungs are normal.